Good morning everyone. Yesterday we have started with the point that is tissue level of organization. In that we have studied a few points, like we have started with the epithelial tissue. We have already discussed about this particular point, that is types of cell junctions in the cellular level of organization, and we have started with the epithelial tissue classification. So we will study further points under the epithelial tissue in this lecture. Okay, so this is all we have covered till now. Characteristics of epithelial tissue. These are very important characteristics, and you have to remember this. Okay, this will help you to understand the differentiation between epithelial tissue and the other types of tissues. Okay, so final classification is epithelium can be divided into simple and stratified. So as I said yesterday, like we have the name, that is first name and the surname, the epithelium also have the first name and the surname. So the first name is depending on the number of layers which are present, and the last name, that is surname, is depending on the cell shape. So there are particularly three types of cell shape, that is squamous, that is flattened type of cells, second one is cuboidal, and third one is columnar. Okay, so simple epithelium, when we say, it is nothing but single layer of cells, and the stratified epithelium means there are multiple layer of cells in the epithelium. Okay, so simple squamous epithelium, simple cuboidal epithelium, simple columnar epithelium, and the fourth type, which is unrelated to the classification scheme which we have just discussed, it is pseudo stratified columnar. Okay, so you have to just remember this fourth name as a special case. The other three ones, they are they follow the same scheme of classification. So under stratified, there is stratified squamous, stratified cuboidal, stratified columnar, and the fourth one, again it differs from the other classification scheme, that is transitional epithelium. Okay, so let's start with the types of epithelium. So the first type over here, it is simple squamous epithelium. So whenever we will discuss the epithelial tissue or any other type of tissue, it will have three points, or the content of it will be divided under three titles, that is first one is structure, second is function, and third one is location. Okay, so whenever if question appears in your examination, then you have to write the answer to the question in this format only. Okay, so you can first of all describe the structure of the epithelial tissue or any other tissue there under, then you have to write the function of that tissue, and that third thing is you have to locate that tissue. Location means what? In body, where you will find this type of particular tissue. Okay, so that will be the location, and it is not always possible that you are able to draw a three-dimensional structure. Just whenever you are drawing the structure of any kind of a tissue, just keep in mind that whatever structure you are drawing, it should coincide with the description which you are writing over here. Okay, so when we say flattened cells, the structure which you are drawing should also look like flattened cells. Okay, it should not be you are drawing columnar cells and writing the structure description as the flattened cells. It should not happen that way. Okay, so let's see first of all the structure of simple squamous epithelium. So whenever we are writing the title as simple squamous epithelium, few things, they are already there in the name itself. Simple means single layer, squamous means flattened. Okay, so it is single layer of thin flattened cells. Okay, so this description, it directly came from this. Okay, So it looks like fried egg. So you know that how a fried egg looks like. Okay, as I don't eat the egg, I don't know how it looks like, but it must be like this. Okay, so the central portion will be the yellow part of the yellow part of the egg, and the rest part is the white part. Okay, egg white. So it gets easily damaged. So function of the simple squamous epithelium is present commonly at the site of filtration, diffusion, osmosis, cover surfaces. Okay, so as it is a flat type of cells, it is thin layer. That's why you will find it at filtration sites, at diffusion. Diffusion, when we are saying diffusion, we are specifically talking about gases. Okay, so diffusion of gases usually happens in blood vessels. In blood vessels, if we consider the blood vessel, the oxygen moves out of the blood vessel and the carbon dioxide moves in. Okay, so this movement of oxygen from this point to this point and of carbon dioxide from this point to this point, it is diffusion only. It is simple diffusion only. Okay, so diffusion, wherever it happens, you will find the simple squamous epithelium lying to that particular wall. Okay, so osmosis, again we have studied what is the osmosis. Then also it covers the surfaces. So location where you will find this, so wherever these functions are carried out, that is filtration, diffusion and osmosis, at that particular site you will find the simple squamous epithelium. So let's see the location, that is air sacs of the lungs, second walls of capillaries. When I'm saying capillaries, I'm talking about the blood capillaries. Then air sacs of the lungs, respiration, it is related to respiration. So at this level of the air sacs, the carbon dioxide moves inside and the oxygen moves outside. Okay, so linings of the blood and lymph vessel. Okay, so the filtration or diffusion happens at the blood and lymph vessels, that's why it is present over there. Okay, so next type of epithelium is simple cuboidal epithelium. So from name itself you can describe the structure, that is single layer, simple, cuboidal, cube shaped cells. Simple. Okay, from name itself you can write at least two words, two three words you can write about this epithelium under the structure. Okay, so next thing is important, centrally located nucleus. Okay, so every cell as it has a nucleus, in case of cuboidal epithelium you will find the nucleus which is present at the center. So this is actually histological section of the simple cuboidal epithelium. So this red color thing, it is nothing but the nucleus. Okay, so you can see the shape of the simple cuboidal epithelium, it is cube shape. Okay, so please understand that you won't find exact cube in each of the cell, but approximately when we say the shape is cuboidal in nature. Okay, so this is cube shape. Okay, and this is the nucleus. Okay, so what is function? If you see, when we have mentioned the function of the, let me go to that particular slide. We have enlisted four functions: protection, absorption, filtration, secretion. So whatever types of the epithelial tissue we are seeing, all of them will have either of the function. Okay, that means out of these four functions, at least one function will be played by that particular subtype of that epithelial tissue. Okay, so I'll just go there. Okay, so the function is secretion and absorption. So where secretion happens? Surface of ovaries, linings of kidney tubules. So one of the function of when I say kidney tubules, I'm specifically talking about PCT, DCT, collecting duct, loop. Okay, so one of the function of the this nephron is tubular secretion. Also it causes reabsorption. Okay, so if we see both these function, secretion and absorption, they are carried out by the kidney tubules. Okay, so you will find this simple cuboidal epithelium in the linings of the kidney tubule, and also you will find simple cuboidal epithelium in the linings of ducts of certain gland. Okay, so we are going to see what is this duct and what is the gland. Okay, so in the epithelium only, there is another type of epithelium apart from covering and lining, that is glandular epithelium. That time we will be studying about what is this duct. Okay, so next is simple columnar epithelium. Okay, so the shape of cells is column like okay, so it is elongated layer of cells with nuclei at same level. So understand this thing, it also has the nuclei, but the nuclei is at the same level. You won't find one nuclei over here, one nuclei over here, one here, like this you won't find. You will find the nuclei at the same level. So this is a diagrammatic representation, this is histological representation. So you can find the nuclei, which is blue colored, which you can see over here. It is all at the same level. Okay, so the function which is played by simple columnar epithelium is absorption, protection, secretion. Okay, so when it opens to body cavity, it is called as mucous membranes. So important. It is very important. So when it is open to body cavities, it is called as mucous membranes. So special features which are associated with simple columnar epithelium, that is, first one is microvilli and second one is goblet cell. So what is a microvilli? It is bumpy extension of apical surface. Apical surface is the one which faces to the exterior. Okay, so it is bumpy extension of apical surface. It increases surface area and the rate of absorption. Okay, so here you can see small projections are there in this particular region. So this thing is nothing but the microvilli. What is the function of it? To increase the surface area, and also as the surface area increases, rate of absorption increases. So second special feature of the simple columnar epithelium is goblet cells. So what are goblet cells? They are single cell glands. They produce protective mucus. Okay, so they are specifically glands, and when we say anything as a gland, it has a function, that is secretion. Okay, so in case of the simple columnar epithelium, in between these columnar epithelial cells, you will find one such cell, that is goblet cell, which is a gland, and What secretion it secretes? It secretes mucus. And what is function of this mucus? It is protection. Okay. So location where you will find this simple columnar epithelium? Linings of entire digestive tract. Okay. So when I say linings, I am talking about inner lining. Okay. So you know digestive tract actually starts from the mouth, then it goes to esophagus, then stomach, then small intestine and large intestine. The entire inner portion of this digestive tract, it is covered by the simple columnar epithelium. And why it is covered by the simple columnar epithelium? Because these special structures associated with simple columnar epithelium actually help in increasing surface area, and also it helps in the increase in rate of absorption. And as we know, the digestive system is responsible for breaking down of complex molecules into simpler molecules, and those simpler molecules which are formed, then they are absorbed into the systemic circulation. So we require any type of a tissue that allows easy movement of the substances across the gastrointestinal tract wall. So this simple columnar epithelium, as it provides special structure like microvilli, it actually allows the absorption to happen. And also, as it has a goblet cell in between the columnar cells, it allows protection against harsh environment. So where harsh environment is present in gastrointestinal tract, it is present in the stomach. Okay, so in stomach, as you know, there are certain type of cells that produce hydrochloric acid. The pH of the stomach is acidic in nature. So if there is no any other defense mechanism, if it is present, then what will happen? The acid will burn out the cells. But it doesn't happen in case of stomach. Why? Because in stomach, these goblet cells are present in between the columnar cells, and these goblet cells, as they produce mucus, it forms a uniform layer, uniform protective layer across the internal wall of the stomach, and this protective layer protects against harsh effects of the hydrochloric acid. Okay, so next is pseudo stratified columnar epithelium. So structure, pseudo means false. Okay, so falsely it looks like stratified. That means falsely it looks like the cells, it is made up of multiple layers of cells, but it is not true. That means it is false. So why it looks like multiple layers of cells are there in this particular type of epithelium? Because the arrangement of the nuclei, in case of simple columnar epithelium, we have said that the nuclei are arranged at the same level. They are present at the same level. But in case of this pseudo-stratified columnar epithelium, as the nuclei are present at the different levels, that's why it looks like there are multiple layers of cell in this particular type of epithelium. But as it is not true, that's why it is called as pseudo-stratified columnar epithelium. And why it is called as columnar epithelium? Because the type of cells which are present or which form this type of epithelium, it is columnar cells. Okay, so structure, irregularly shaped cells with nuclei at different level, as I said earlier, it appears stratified, but it aren't. okay, so all cells reach basement membrane. This is important. Okay, so even though the arrangement of nuclei is at different levels, but all the cells which form this particular type of epithelium, they reach at the basement membrane. Okay, so their basal surface is attached to the basement membrane. That's why it is pseudostratified columnar epithelium. So the function of it is again absorption and secretion. So as these are columnar epithelium, you will find goblet cells in between these columnar cells, and they produce mucus. Also, it shows presence of cilia. So cilia, they are larger than microvilli. Okay, so they are basically a hair like structure, and what function they play? They sweep the mucus. Okay, sweep the mucus means what? The mucus will be produced by the goblet cell. Okay, so these cilia, as they beat in unison, means what? If this cilia, if it moves in this direction, then these both other cilia, they will move in the same direction. That is beating in unison. Okay, it is not that it will move in this direction, then this will move in this direction, and this will move in this direction. No, it is not so. All the cilia which are present on the apical surface of the columnar cell, they will move in the same direction. So as they move in the same direction, whatever mucus present by the goblet cell, it is then swept, or it is then moved in the forward direction. So this mucus will move. If the cilia are moving in this direction, this mucus will get attached to the cilia, and as cilia beat in unison, the mucus will also move in forward direction. Okay, in this direction. So why it is important? It depends on the location. In respiratory linings, you will find this also in reproductive tract. So first of all, we will discuss about respiratory tract. So in a respiratory tract, we say that we have a cuff. Okay, cuff is a yellow looking, foul smelling, semi-solid substance that comes out through our mouth when we have that cuff. Okay, so cuff, we can say in both ways, that cuff as that mucus and cuff as that of in Marathi khokla. Okay, when we have khokla, that time the cuff also is there. Okay, so there is two type of cuff, that is dry cuff and productive cuff. So we are basically talking about productive cuff, when the expectoration or the removal of cuff happens from the throat. Okay, so how this cuff comes out from the respiratory tract into your mouth, and then you just spit it out? It is because of movement of the cilia. Okay, so the cuff or this mucus which is produced, it is, as I said earlier, it has some protective function. It protects us against the ill effects of the bacteria, or any type of microorganism. They try to get inside our respiratory tract and try to damage our respiratory tract. But as this mucus is being produced by the goblet cell, this mucus, as it is very sticky in nature, it binds to the, or it catches the bacteria in it, and it destroys those particular bacteria. Okay, so as the bacteria, they get trapped in the mucus, it turns yellow. Okay, so if the mucus, if it get accumulated in the respiratory tract, then it will just choke up the respiratory tract and it will cause breathlessness. But as cilia are present on the apical surface of these columnar cells, what happens, these cilia, they move this curve which is accumulated in our respiratory tract to exterior, okay, that is to outside towards mouth, okay. So when this curve comes in our mouth by the action of cilia, we spit it out, okay. So in case of reproductive tract, the sperm or the ovum, when ovum meets with the sperm, it forms zygote, okay. So plantation of zygote happens in the uterus. Although the ovum is there in the ovary, but at the time in the ovum is invaded by the sperm, its plantation happens into the uterus, and the zygote needs to travel from the ovary through the fallopian tube into the uterus, okay. So in that reproductive tract, these cilia are present. So what these cilia do, these cilia move the zygote from the ovary into the uterus. So these cilia, as they beat in unison, as the zygote comes and attaches to the cilia, due to their beating in unison style, this zygote moves towards the uterus and gets planted in the uterus. Okay, so this is pseudostratified columnar epithelium. So next is stratified squamous epithelium. So name stratified squamous. So structure, many layers, that's why stratified. So it is usually cuboidal columnar at bottom, squamous at top. This is important. So whatever cells which are present at the top, they are of shape that is squamous. But whatever cells present at the bottom, they are either cuboidal or columnar. Okay. So function of it is to give protection. Also, keratin, which is a type of protein, is accumulated in older cells near the surface. It waterproofs and toughens the skin. So keratin, which is a type of protein, it gets accumulated at the cells which are present in this uppermost layer, and as this keratin gets accumulated in this uppermost layer, it allows waterproofing and also it toughens the skin. So location of this stratified squamous epithelium, it is very common, that is, it is present in skin, okay. So keratinized. So if you see that whenever you have bath, the water doesn't stay on the on your skin for long, okay. Why it doesn't stay on your skin for long? The reason is that the keratinized cells of the skin, they don't allow water to get absorbed or get into the skin, okay. If the water gets inside your skin, then after every bath you will gain some weight. But as the keratin protein is there in the outermost layer of the skin, there is no chance of water getting into your body through the skin, and you are not gaining any weight after every bath. Okay. So second location of this is in the mouth, and also it is present in the throat. Okay. So next is stratified cuboidal epithelium. So it has two or more layers of cells in apical layer. these are cube shape, fairly rare type. Okay, so this is important. In not many places you will find this stratified cuboidal epithelium. So two or more layers of cells, that is cuboidal shaped cells, you will find in apical layer. So when I say apical layer, I'm not talking about apical surface, I'm talking about apical layer. Okay, so if there are four or five layers, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, okay, so this becomes the stratified. So in first 2, 3 layers, 1, 2, 3 layers, whatever the shape of cells, it will be cuboidal. Okay, so below to this, the shape of cell will be maybe the columnar type of cells or irregular type of cells. Okay, so function it plays is protection, limited secretion and absorption. Okay, so location of this type of epithelium is ducts of adult sweat glands, esophageal glands, part of male urethra. Okay, so next, again a fairly rare type of epithelium, that is stratified columnar epithelium. So basal layer usually consists of shortened irregularly shaped cells. Apical layer has columnar cells. So as I said, like in case of stratified cuboidal epithelium, only apical layer has the type of cells, type of shape of cells, as we have mentioned over here, but other at the base they will have irregular shaped cells. Okay, so like the stratified cuboidal epithelium, it is also uncommon. Okay, so the function which is played by it, it is protection and secretion. Location of it is lines part of urethra, large excretory ducts of some glands, small areas in anal mucous membrane and part of conjunctiva of eye. Okay, so next one, it is very important, that is transitional epithelium. Okay, from the name itself you don't get exact idea about whether it is stratified or it is simple, what type of cell shape is there, but one thing you may get from the name itself, it is the transition. Okay, so what is transition? It is change. So change in what? Change in shape. Okay, so transitional epithelium, it changes shape in certain situations. So when in a location we will see, that is urinary bladder. So urinary bladder, it is known to store the urine. Okay, it stores the urine. Okay, so as it stores the urine, when the urination happens, when the micturition happens, the amount of urine which is present in the urinary bladder is becomes less or negligible. That time the urinary bladder wall is in a relaxed state, and when the amount of urine increases in the bladder, the volume of urine, it produces some kind of, or it causes some kind of stretch onto the wall of urinary bladder. So that time the wall gets distended. Okay, so relaxed when after urination and distended when urine is accumulated in the urinary bladder. So at the time of this particular relaxed state, the cell shape is cuboidal or columnar at surface. Okay, so when the urinary bladder wall is relaxed, the cell shape is cuboidal or columnar. But when this urinary bladder wall gets distended, the same cuboidal or columnar shaped cells, they will become squamous. Okay, so they will become squamous. That means they will get flattened up and they will also get a look of simple epithelium. During relaxed state, they will have look of stratified, but during distension, that is presence of stage, they will get look of simple epithelium, and also the shape of cell, it will change to the squamous. Okay, here the shape of cell is cuboidal or columnar. Okay, so function is it allows stretching, that is change in size and shape. Okay, so next is glands. So as I said, epithelium, there are two types of epithelium. First type of epithelium is covering and lining, and second type of epithelium is glandular epithelium. So what are glands? One or more cells that make and secrete a product. So secretion is by the glands. So what is secretion? It is protein in aqueous solution, hormones, acids, oils. So it can be anything. It can be hormones, it can be acid, or it can be oil. Okay, so it is secretion. So endocrine glands, they have no duct. Duct, when I say duct, it is like a pipeline. Okay, it doesn't, they don't have a pipe through which they can put out their secretions onto the surface. Okay, so what these endocrine glands do, they release their secretion into the blood vessels. Okay, so often whatever secretions they produce, they are called as hormones. So examples are, these are only representative ones, that is thyroid, adrenal and pituitary glands. So exocrine glands, they contain duct. So if question is asked to differentiate between exocrine and endocrine, so this should be the first point, that is in case of endocrine there is no duct, in case of exocrine there is duct. Okay, so they empty onto the epithelial surface. So examples of the exocrine gland contains sweat, oil glands, salivary glands and mammary glands. Okay, so sweat glands produce sweat, oil glands produce oil, we call it as sebum. Then salivary glands, they produce saliva, mammary glands, they produce milk. So this is the structure of the thyroid gland. You will find this transverse sections when we will see in practicals. You have a particular topic, that is microscopical study of the certain organs and tissue. That time you will study about the TS of thyroid gland. Okay, so also we have anatomy and physiology of thyroid gland. That time also you will study about this. Okay, then this is secretory portion of the sweat gland. So this is sweat gland. TS of it, when it is taken, it looks like this. Okay, so this central portion is duct. These are the cells that produce a type of secretions, and these secretions are put into the duct, and by means of duct they are carried onto the surface. Okay, so classification of exocrine gland, depending on branching, they can be of two types, simple and compound, and depending on shape, they can be of type, that is tubular, acinar or tubulo acinar. So like the scheme of classification which we have applied for the covering and lining type of epithelium, same scheme can be applied over here, that this branching will form the first name and the shape will form the surname. Okay, so branching, there is two type of branching, that is simple, so single unbranched duct. So when we are saying branching, we are talking about branching of duct or pipeline. Okay, so compound is branched, so this will become the single duct if the same duct is branched as it is shown like this roughly, then it becomes the compound. Okay, so shape can be tubular, tube like shape structure, then acinar or alveolar, it is rounded shape. Tubuloacinar, it is combination of these two type of shapes, that is tubuloacinar or tubuloalveolar, both tubular and more rounded. Okay, so now the classification is, we are combining the first name with the surname, simple tubular, simple branched tubular, simple coiled tubular, simple acinar, simple branched acinar, compound tubular, compound acinar, compound tubuloacinar. See, when we are saying branched, the duct is the same. Okay, this is the duct. Okay, but when this duct extends, it branches it like this. Okay, understand the difference between this, that here in case of this, the duct is this, the duct is getting branched. Okay, so depending on branching of duct, it can be classified as simple or compound. You may get confused between this type, simple branched and the compound, but see, the duct is the same. This blue colored portion is the duct. Here the blue colored portion is extended till this. Okay, so this branching is happening over here also. Okay, but the branching of the duct is also happening, that's why it is called as compound. Okay, so the types are simple tubular, simple branched tubular, simple coiled tubular, simple acinar. Acinar shape, you can see it is more rounded at this particular point, and the simple branched acinar, so branching is there, so rounded portion at the at this particular point. Okay, so tubular structure, it is less bulged portion over here, it is more like a tube. Okay, so this next point, that is connective tissue, we will study in next lecture. Okay, that's all from my side, and that's all for the epithelial tissue. Thank you.